Married at First Sight Season 11 New Orleans is here. Well, almost. And they just announced the 5 couples that we are going to see this season. And guess what? I am on the show. Well, kind of. I'm kind of on the show. I will get more into that in a couple of seconds. But first, we have to talk about who are these 5 couples and what we can expect from this new Season 11. Guys, I am so excited. Let's not waste any more time and just jump right into who are these couples. Number one, starting off with Henry and Christina. Boom, right there, that is their picture. Henry, 35, currently works as a clinical recruiter. He's looking to settle down, but feels he tried every approach possible, aside from Married at First Sight. Christina, 30, is a flight attendant who recently got out of a 5-year relationship. Since then, she hasn't put that much effort into dating. Okay, first looks, 30, 35, there's the picture of them. They seem attractive, they seem mature, they seem to kind of mesh. I don't know anything more than that description. So 30, 35, decent age range. The only thing I don't like off of first glance is I heard flight attendant. It said Christina was a flight attendant. I don't love that. It just seems like flight attendants don't ever do settling down well. I could be wrong, it's just an assumption, but it's just like, geez, they're always traveling, they're always out and about. I don't know if they're gonna have enough time to really settle down and make it work, but who knows. Next couple is Bennett and Amelia. Bennett, 28, grew up in New Jersey and is the artistic director of a theater company. He's looked for a life partner for years, but found himself in a string of bad relationships. Will Married at First Sight be the key? Then he is marrying Amelia, 27, was raised in Virginia. She's continuing the family tradition and completing her medical residency. Her grandparents were in an arranged marriage, so she thinks it's possible to learn to love someone. Wow, that has to be the first person to ever go on the show that has roots of family members that were also technically kind of married at first sight. I did not know that, that is crazy. So 28, 27, it's a solid age range, you know, not too young, not too old. There are their clothes. His suit is definitely different, but it said he's an artistic director of a theater company, so clearly the guy must be somewhat artistic. I will say though, artistic theater director and doctor, it said something about a medical doctor, that just seems like two totally different careers, kind of odd. Either way, the next couple we have is Woody and Amani. Says Woody, 30, hails from New Orleans where he is currently a teacher and coach. He's ready to find a partner to share what he learned from his mother. Amani, 29, was raised in Chicago before moving to New Orleans for college. She works in the nonprofit sector and aspires to open her own nonprofit organization working with the youth. Attractive couple, they both seem to be rooted in the community. It sounds like he's a teacher, she wants to start a nonprofit. The only little thing I see at first glance is, I think she's got like an inch on him. I mean, look at that picture. She seems taller than him, which she might have had heels on, but I know, I hate to go there, I hate to say that. I'm sorry. I can't speak for all women. I'm not a woman, I don't know. So maybe the women that are watching this can comment. Now, I have met women before that are okay with being taller, they get it, they're cool with it. It just seems like maybe 8 times out of 10, so not all, but majority of women would like to be shorter than their man, but maybe she doesn't care. That's the only thing I see at first glance that's kind of a red flag. Then we have Brett and Olivia. Brett, 35, was born and raised in Louisiana. He works in IT and is ready for the Married at First Sight experts to find him his perfect match. Olivia, 30, returned to New Orleans for a position with Comprehensive Stroke Center. Having established her career, she's ready to put the effort into a relationship. Brett and Olivia, there you guys go. You can see a picture for them. Not bad. They look pretty plain Jane, you know, kind of just there. They kind of look like an AJ and Steph from a few seasons ago. They're just kind of there. They're a little bit on the older side. Maybe they just want to find their life partner, settle down, and just, you know, live together, be happily ever after. But they're not real picky because they're kind of in the older, you know, crowd. I could be wrong. I have absolutely no idea. They seem pretty plain Jane. And they, you know, both look attractive, and I wouldn't be shocked if they're both into each other. And last but not least is Miles and Karen. Miles, 26, is passionate about education and enjoys working with children and young adults. Karen, 30, works as a consultant in New Orleans. She's been single for 5 years and finds dating to be quite difficult. Well, we got some good, we got some bad. Number one, the first bad, I thought I read that wrong, but that actually said Miles is 26 and Karen is 30. So, whoa. Yeah, that is just like not good. You can call me crazy, you can call me rude, but I'm not liking that age gap. It's just like, no, yeah, I rarely ever see a woman that is like super cool being older than the man. A year or two, yeah, okay, maybe, but 4 years is kind of significant. Another thing that this seems kind of odd is that Karen hasn't been in a relationship for 5 years. Now, I totally get it. Hey, I'm practically right there with her, but it's like, that's kind of been a long time to just be single for and then jump into marriage. I don't know if she's going to be able to get in the swing of everything with being married, you know, from being single for so long to then you're married, you're with the person 24/7. I don't really love that. But I will say they do seem to look good together. I liked Miles' suit. It's a cool looking suit, looks good. She looks attractive, he looks like a good looking guy. So maybe they'll be into each other. I just don't love that age gap. So guys, those are the five couples that we are going to see in the new season of Married at First Sight, New Orleans season 11. And yes, I did a little snippet. I made a comment that I am actually going to be on this season, kind of, sort of. So what happened was I was asked, it was just a blessing out of, you know, God, out of the universe. It was amazing that they asked me to be on this little kickoff special that is airing on July 8th. So the first episode, the matchmaking episode, is going to air on Lifetime on July 8th. After that matchmaking special, me and three others and Kevin Frazier are going to do a little, you know, fun just banter of going back and forth on the couples, what we think, pretty much what I do every single day here, but with three others and Kevin Frazier, and I can't say too much until it airs. So it's going to air on July 8th. All I can say is, guys, if you want to support this channel, and I'll bring it up a couple more times so everyone remembers, but if you want to support this channel and you have a TV and you have a Lifetime channel, watch it. See what you guys think. It's just like watching my videos here. I had a phenomenal time recording it. It was a blast. It's going to be a quarantine special kind of like this with everything going on. And it was just a really big blast. I had so much fun. So check it out, July 8th. It's going to be a blast to watch. I'm a little bit nervous, but it was really fun. We had a great conversation, a lot of laughs. It was really a good time. So make sure to check that out on July 8th. And those are the couples. Now, a few of you guys asked, do I have any spoilers? I honestly don't have. I know just about as much as you guys know from reading what I just read. There's not much that I have seen that you guys haven't heard. So I don't have any spoilers. I'm only in that one little episode for now. Maybe more to come. Who knows? Hopefully. And I also want to say, guys, I hit 50,000 subscribers yesterday on YouTube, which is just out of this world, insane, crazy, can't even put words behind it. It's just so unbelievable. I started this channel on August 5th or 6th of 2019. Never thought it would go anywhere. Never thought anyone would actually watch the videos. And now it's got 50,000 subscribers. So I wanted to just say thank you all. It means the world to me. I just don't even know what to say. I'm speechless. Unbelievable. I love making these videos. You guys are all just a bunch of rock stars, amazingly awesome people. And I just love all you guys so much. So I wanted to say thank you. It was a huge milestone for me. It means the world. And I wanted to say how much I love and appreciate all of you guys. So thank you for subscribing. And if you haven't already subscribed, I don't know what you guys are waiting for. And I'll also put my Instagram channel below if you want to give me a follow on there. Well, thank you so much for watching, guys. And make sure to stay tuned for many more videos.